What's up, YouTube watchers? I'm Skylar Gray, and here is my playlist. So I'm going to tell you some of my favorite videos of all time, some of my favorite videos that I'm currently into, and I'm going to start with Hurt by Johnny Cash. Originally a Nine Inch Nails song, I know, but the Johnny Cash version is insane. Every time I watch this video, I cry. Every single time, I cry. It's so powerful. Second on the list is Stand by Eminem. Again, one of the coolest songs of all time. And the video really does it justice, I think. And I really like at the beginning how she's singing on a toilet. I thought that was a really nice touch. Criminal by Fiona Apple. One of my favorite songs ever. And the video I really like because it was simple and it's lit with like one light, I think, on the camera or something, kind of following her around in this house. And it's really dark and sexy and I don't know, I just love it. Middle Class Rhett, Busy Being Born. I discovered this band through this video. I randomly saw it playing on somebody's screen at a radio station when I was on a radio promo tour, and I just thought it was really interesting how they took a fight club and made it like a kid's fight club. Or like cockfighting or something. I don't really know. It was like, yeah, it's kind of a fucked up video, but you should watch it. Possessed LB3, another really random find. I was in my attorney's office in New York, and his associate was there kind of looking at videos on YouTube, and she had just discovered this kid, LB3, of Phony People, who I still pretty much know nothing about, but I love this video and I love this song. She showed it to me and I just was like, this is really cool, and it stuck with me. Let's see, what's next? Moby Southside featuring Gwen Stefani. This is a really interesting video because Joseph Kahn is kind of showing a little bit behind the scenes of how a music video is made in a sterile setting, like a studio, and you're doing all this dumb shit sometimes to be cool or whatever in a video, like wearing a fur jacket or whatever it is, and it's not even real, it's like some bullshit. So I like how he kind of points that out in this video. Okay, now I'm gonna go into some funny things. Somebody on Twitter actually recommended this one to me, the bad lip reading Hunger Games. Diego, thank you for this. I really laughed a lot when I watched it. I am a Hunger Games fan too, so it made it even funnier, I guess. But I always like it when people take videos and then take the audio off and replace it with something else. But I thought they did a really good job with this one. Let's see. Fainting goats are like the coolest creatures on the planet, right? Come on. And then Shane sings Five Octaves. Actually, Dave Siddick from TV on the Radio sent me this link, and I was dying. I was totally dying. Because to me, one of the greatest things in life is bad singing. I think it's hilarious, and I like to do it as a hobby. I like to sing off-key on purpose. And this guy, Shane, it seems like he really believes that he's singing five octaves. I mean, I'm sorry to break it to you, man, but you're not even coming close. And let's see, what do I have here? Is that it? No, one more. This one is actually really special. This one's really actually special to me because It's aerial footage of a ranch on the southern coast of Oregon. My friends own this ranch. They have grass-fed beef, cranberry bogs, and they have this amazing piece of land right on the ocean in Oregon. And one of the guys on the ranch is a pilot, so they took all this aerial footage. So you're flying over, listening to music, and it's just stunning. One of the most beautiful places I think I've ever been in the whole entire world. And I've been a lot of places. And if you're interested in grass-fed beef, you should check out OregonGrassFed.com. That's it, you guys. Hope you like my video choices.